Hey Aries, thank you so much for coming to your monthly love reading. This love reading should resonate for Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. Those of you that are cross-watching, welcome. It can be your situation or your partner's. It kind of just depends, so keep that in mind. Sometimes you do have to flip it. Okay, so I do want to say this. When I meditated on your energy, Aries, again, it's interesting because I feel like there's a lot of stability. I also feel like there's a lot of harmony. I really feel like there's something stable here. I feel like for some of you guys, you're definitely entering into a commitment. And this is something I feel like you've wanted for a period of time. I also feel like there's something very comforting and sexual or sensual. I'm sorry. Woo, maybe it is sexual. But this is really about a level of self-care and investing in yourself and also investing in your partner as well. Okay, so that's the first thing I wanted to say to you before I even get into it. Now, I've meditated and I've pulled a card for your message, and your message is the armadillo spirit, which is funny because when I was shuffling and the card flew out, I'm like, yo, if this is armadillo spirit, I'm done. And for sure, that's exactly what it was. And the armadillo spirit is all about setting healthy boundaries. And I feel like you guys are going to enter in a phase where you're really going to have to make sure that you set boundaries, especially with people. Because here's the thing a lot of people don't realize about Aries. Aries are givers, okay? I've never met one Aries that didn't give. I lied. There was one dude, he was not a giver. Anyways, but for the most part, all the other Aries that I've ever come in contact with, they're givers. Like you guys are givers. You guys give things. That's what you do, right? And sometimes I feel like Aries, you give too much of yourself to people and places and things that really are not supposed to have your time and energy. So with the armadillo spirit here, it's really about saying like you are the co-creator of your life, and it's okay to say no to certain things. And this is also setting boundaries with people, okay? I feel like when you have the ability to set boundaries, set healthy boundaries, this is what I'm comfortable with, this is what I'm not, okay? For instance, if it's important to you that somebody calls you every day or has a level of communication, that is a boundary. If that person breaks that boundary, you're breaking my boundary and you're affecting my mental health, right? Like, it's almost saying like whatever is not serving me, whatever's causing me a level of anxiety, you have to set those boundaries in order for there to be a level of elevation and progression inside of your relationship. Here's what's interesting. You also have these cards that came out as well. So we have Secret Admirer, and we also have Freedom. And this is someone has deeper feelings for you than they're letting on. So I definitely feel like, Aries, there's somebody that has a very strong emotional connection to you. They just may not be communicating that. Also, too, your card is Freedom. There's nothing stopping you. The path is clear if you want it to be. So if you want to be with somebody, right now, you have the green light, but what they're telling you is set boundaries. You cannot go from a place where you're somewhat stable, right, to a place where it's all confusion and jacked up again. So it's really about setting boundaries and understanding that if you want something right now, your path is clear, and whatever was stopping you prior, that's no longer an issue, okay, for this month. All right. Let's get into your reading, Aries. What's the overall energy for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus? Aries, overall energy. Wow, look at this. Okay, Ace of Wands, Queen of Cups. Some of you may be dealing with a Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. I feel like that would be secondary, though. So Cancer, Pisces, I feel like those ones are, I'm sorry, Pisces, Scorpio. I feel like it'd be like Moon, Rising, or Venus. For me, this is a strong Cancer card. But taking away the signs, this is going to be a moment where you have a level of emotional fulfillment. I also feel like you have a lot of freedom and a lot of creative freedom. And there's something here that you're nurturing that's new. And I feel like there is some type of brand new potential coming in for you guys. Okay. What is Aries' person of interest? What is their energy in their relationship? What is Aries' person of interest? What is their energy? Okay, High Priestess wanting to come out when it just did. All right, some of you guys, you may not be speaking with this person. This person may be very quiet, and I think that you may be curious, like, what the heck they're doing. How does Aries feel about this person romantically? How does Aries feel about their person of interest romantically? Page of Swords. I think that there is a level of curiosity. So you have Taurus, you also have Gemini, Aquarius, or Libra. What is the current situation, the romantic situation between these two? What is the romantic situation between Aries and their person? The Two of Cups. Okay, there's Venus in Cancer. And let me pull your outcome card. What's the best potential outcome for these two romantically? What's the best potential outcome for these two romantically? Okay, soulmate came out and express your love. Like I said, I do feel like this month, there is something that's done where I do feel like there is a level of communication and I feel like it is a new start. But I feel like it starts with like a very light and kind of like fun energy. Because your person is coming in as their role right now as a high priestess. So I feel like for you, you're not exactly sure what's going on because maybe this person has shut you out completely. Let me clarify this and then we'll get into your reading, okay? Whoa, shit, that just flew out. All right. What's the overall energy for love and romance for Aries? Okay, mask. That's funny. Because remember, what your card was secret admirer. So I do feel like you have somebody new that is curious about you. And I do feel like there is somebody you may be around that's not showing you their true feelings. What is their energy in the relationship? Aries person of interest. What's Aries person of interest energy in this relationship? Okay. Boat. How does Aries feel about their person of interest? How does Aries feel about this person of interest? I feel like you guys want to talk. Yep. Engagement ring. What is the current situation between these two? Cupid's arrow. Okay. Here's what I think. I feel like this. The fact that the situation is a Two of Cups, but your person is coming in as a High Priestess and how you feel about them is a Page of Swords. Here's what I'm gathering. I think that there's a lot of passion between you and this person. And it's a lot of emotional connections, soul ties. That's what I'm gathering. And I think that when you have that type of commitment or that type of relationship with somebody, feelings, it's very easy for things to go sideways because I feel like with this situation, if you try to be too logical about what's going on, you're never going to understand it. And this situation is going to continue to have the same issues because I feel like right now, Aries, to be honest, this is a situation that I feel like I said, I feel like there's soul ties here. I feel like this is definitely a soulmate. Obviously, you have this card. I also feel like, too, you and this person together, you guys can work on things, but I do feel like somebody needs to be recognized here. Somebody's been doing the work. Somebody's been working on something for a period of time. And I do feel like somebody's been doing the hard work with themselves as well. And it's creating a level of growth and change. All right. So why is this their overall energy? Why is this Aries overall energy? Why is this Aries? Okay, with the Magician. So Aries, Gemini, Virgo, Scorpio, or you. I feel like you're really sitting down, Aries. Like, I feel like you're sitting there and you're really thinking about exactly what I want. And I feel like you're visualizing exactly what you need in order for a level of emotional fulfillment. And I also feel like, too, you're not ready to give up on a situation. It's like you want to give it one last try. Or like, how does my goddaughter say? She says, give it a go. Like, there's something here about wanting to figure this out. Because the potential here between you and this person is insane. And I think that that's part of the problem. I also think, too, with this Queen of Cups, I feel like somebody's definitely hiding how they feel. Think about this. This is Cancer. Cancer's a crab. It has that hard shell, but then all the soft meat in the inside. So I feel like right now, somebody's going to have to let their guard down, right? And I feel like when you let your guard down, that is going to be a huge conduit for a very powerful love to come in, or for this person to drop their mask. I also feel like too, if you were feeling emotionally overwhelmed, or if you were distracted, or even like remembering like things that you've done with this person, I feel like there's a deeper insight to why this person is moving the way that they're moving. And I think that you need to uncover why, because this person is very secretive. This person has a lot of secrets. This person has been through a lot. And I also feel like this person is highly intuitive. What are they manifesting? What's being manifested here for the overall energy for Aries? One more time. What's being manifested here for the overall energy for Aries? What's Aries manifesting? What's being manifested? Working out something that you guys have been thinking about for a period of time. We also have strength here. So some of you guys are definitely manifesting a Leo. I feel like you're trying to be strong right now. And I also feel like for some of you guys, you know that something has to change and that you do have to walk away from something. For some of you, it may be walking away from being single. It can be walking away from, you know, no longer feeling left out, or no longer blocking, you know, somebody saying like, hey, come on in. There's something here to that. And as I said that, there's the Chariot. Some of you may even be at a distance from this person, or maybe of a different culture or different religion. I just feel like you guys having a level of strength, really toning down the ego, I feel like that's what's creating you to be in a very emotional state. This is your energy coming in here is one where it's like you're creating your own reality. But I do feel like somebody's not showing their true feelings. All right. Your person is a High Priestess. I feel like, let me ask, why is this person, their role in the relationship? Why is their role the High Priestess? Why is this because of the Tower? So for some of you guys, there maybe was a split up or a breakup here, possibly with a Taurus or a Libra, or you maybe have Taurus and Libra in your chart. We also have the King of Wands here. So there's Leo, Sag, or Aries. This is also, to me, the King of Wands, I like him, right? He has a vision. He knows what he wants. But I feel like what separated you and your person is ego. I'm going to be honest. I feel like this is heavy ego energy. The King of Wands, especially with the Tower there. Because here's the thing. I feel like this person, it's like they felt like they could change your mind on something. And I feel like either they stood up for themselves or you stood up for yourself. And I think that that person didn't like that. Sorry, I'm over here waving my water bottle. I also feel like this person was being very critical, and maybe there was a level of anger that wasn't in check here. It's like something little, like little things built over time, and then all of a sudden, I feel like everything just blew up out of nowhere. And I feel like it surprised you. And I feel like because of that, there's a lack of communication. One card here, please. What was the Tower? What was the root of the issue? What was the root of this Tower? What was the root of the Tower? I feel like it's ego, or it can be you. Queen of Wands, so there's definitely Aries right there. Aries or Cancer energy with that Queen of Wands. I feel like this. I feel like you really took a step into your power, Aries, and there was something here about breaking some type of conventional boundaries. And like, I feel like you, like you're trying to force this person to see something and really like trust you. However, I do feel like this person, and it's funny because you have the King and the Queen here, right? King of Wands, Queen of Wands. So this is definitely you and your person. I just feel like there was some type of argument and there was ego involved, and I think that it was used the wrong way, and I think that that ego needs to be released, and I feel like somebody was playing games, and there also was a level of jealousy here between you and this person. okay, what's coming from, what's, how does this person feel about this tower moment? How does this person feel about this tower moment? With Aries. The Hermit, Virgo, they're not talking, obviously. They're being very resilient right now. And I think it's because they have a level of anxiety. I feel like their anxiety was building when it came to this. And it's almost like this person is going to a place where they can clear their mind and just really figure out what they want. I also feel like, too, this person wants to receive something from you. It's like there's a closure issue here. I feel like you and this person still have a conversation. You and this person need to have some type of conversation in order either for you guys to move on, whether that's separation completely or move on to the next phase in your relationship, which we'll see more in the extended. So how you feel about them, it's the Page of Swords with engagement ring. I think that, you know, it's funny because pages are always messages, right? I feel like you're waiting for this person to message you. I feel like you don't like the fact that they're not talking to you. I think that for you, you said, no, I'm going to call you and I want you to tell me the truth. Like there's something here about you needing to know the truth. And you're paying attention to everything around you. And I feel like you're questioning your reality and you're trying to keep an open mind with things. But the more that you question, I feel like the more out of balance it becomes. And it's really about walking in your truth. Why is the Page of Swords here for how they feel about their person of interest? Wow, with the Eight of Wands reversed. Again, I just think that for some of you, they may have even blocked you, but I just think it's a lack of communication and it's a lack of action. It's also like things are not changing between the two of you. And I feel like what's happening here is there's no change because both of you are standing your ground instead of working with one another. One more card here for how Aries feels about their person of interest romantically. The Six of Cups. Some of you may be dealing with a Mercury in Sag. This is also Scorpio. Six of Cups. I feel like this is a soulmate connection. I feel like you and this person definitely dream about each other. I feel like you definitely want each other. I feel like there's messages telepathically going back and forth, which some of you may think I'm crazy, but that's coming in strongly. And how you feel about them, it's like they're your comfort zone. You've invested a lot of time. You and this person have gone through a lot. You've had a level of, you know, duality. You've had unity together. I feel like before this big breakup happened, things were going well. There was a level of stability, right? And then boom, challenges hit. And I feel like you're at a place right now where you're in an emotional state. It's no longer a state of anger or frustration for some of you guys. And I don't want to tell you how you feel, but that's how I would read the cards. One more card here for how Aries feels about this person. How does Aries feel about this person? How does Aries feel about their person of interest? Romantically? Wow, that just shot off the thing. Hold on. Hold on, Aries. I can't get the goddamn card up. Page of Wands. For some of you, too, I feel like your partner, again, it's a lot of page energy. I think, Aries, you feel like your partner is, like, immature. There is a level of immaturity here. I do think that you feel like your partner is curious about other people or there may be some other type of relationship, but I also feel like you sense that they're immature. And I feel like that immaturity, it's almost like that Peter Pan complex. And I think I told somebody this yesterday, where it's like they don't want to grow up or what they're doing to you is so immature. Like this person not communicating to you, this person shutting down, this person breaking things off or whatever happened with the breakup, I feel like it was stupid. Like, whatever you and this person are arguing about, like, it's dumb. Because watch. How does Aries feel about the tower moment? How does Aries feel about this tower moment? the Three of Cups. For some of you, there was some type of third party situation with the Two of Swords that you did not know about. Or this could have also been too, somebody going out with friends, something happening here. There was some type of communication, I feel like, that put you in your head. Whatever was communicated by this person, I don't think that you liked it. And the Two of Swords, that's Libra, Moon in Libra. Here's Mercury in Cancer. I feel like with that Moon in Libra, I feel like it's going back and forth. Like, I feel like you go back and forth with whether or not this is a situation that can work or if it's just too far gone. Because I do think that there was something here that was a level of hurt. One more card for how Aries felt about this Tower moment. How does Aries feel about this Tower moment? One more card, please. The Four of Swords. Damn. You know, I just think you felt like it's time to take a break. I feel like it was time to take a break, and I feel like it's giving you the opportunity to really figure out whether or not this is a situation that you want to continue to invest in. That's what I'm getting strongly. Because there is a choice here. You do have a decision with whether or not you want to stay or if you want to go. And I also feel like, too, here, there is a strong sense of friendship. And I feel like when this person did something or something happened between the two of you, it's almost like your friendship didn't even come into play. Just things were just washed out completely. Because you're in your head about it. You're in your head about some type of communication that was said or that was done pertaining to emotions. Okay. However, here's what's funny though, Aries. You feel like this person completes you. And you do want a partnership with them. That's what's interesting. And I feel like it's giving you a level of anxiety because you just want to make things right so that we can have forward movement. All right. We now have Cupid's arrow with the Two of Cups as your situation. I feel like this is a soulmate connection. I feel like there's a lot of love here. But I also feel like the one thing that stands in the way of love is ego. Six of Wands. That's Jupiter and Leo. That's, you know, it's growth, but it's also recognition. I feel like somebody wanted somebody to recognize how they feel emotionally. What's the current situation between these two romantically? Okay, Wheel of Fortune. There's Sag. Sagittarius may have came in between you, or a Capricorn. Okay. You have Four of Pentacles here. And you have the Knight of Wands. So this is, I feel like this. I feel like one person was holding back and one person just kind of wanted to do that. I feel like one person for your situation, I feel like it's a push and pull. And I feel like it's always the same person pushing and it's always the same person pulling back. And I feel like it's, you're tired. And it's like, I've been through so much. Like, I feel like for some of you guys, you're getting ready to give up. I also feel like, though, with the Lovers here and the Devil, there's a Gemini as well as Capricorn or Scorpio. I feel like there is such a strong connection sexually, romantically, passionately. There's something here between you and this person where I feel like you can't see the connection, but you can feel it. It's one of those things like, you can feel it. It's something that you can't explain. And I feel like because of that, especially with the Devil and the Lovers here, it's the energy of the Devil. It's like you and this person are tied to one another. The King of Cups. There you go. So now you have the King and the Queen. But I do feel like this person has a hold over your emotions. And when things go a certain way with them, I feel like it affects every aspect of your life. But here's what's crazy. Your situation is about to change, especially with this card right here, which is the Wheel of Fortune. Have faith. Something is coming in. There may have been a slight hesitation. However, there is a surprise here. And I feel like you and this person are going to end up seeing each other, having a conversation, and really working out exactly what happened between the two of you. Okay. With that being said, Aries, I love you guys. Thank you guys again, and I will talk to you guys next time. Peace.